So guys, you are most welcome in the previous question solution series. तो इस वीडियो में हम बात करेंगे कि जो भी जून 2015 में टू मार्कर के जितने भी क्वेश्चन आए हुए हैं ऑर्गेनिक से, सारे के सारे हम सॉल्व करने जा रहे हैं, राइट। और हम बहुत जल्दी जल्दी सॉल्व करने की कोशिश करेंगे जिससे आपकी प्रैक्टिस भी हो जाए और आपको कॉन्सेप्ट समझ में भी आ जाए। सो लेट्स बिगन विद द टॉपिक एंड द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन वॉज करेक्ट स्टेटमेंट ऑफ द इफेक्ट ऑन एडिशन ऑफ एक्वस एच सी एल ऑन द इक्विलिब्रियम इज, मतलब आपके पास एक कंपाउंड है और इसमें आपको एच सी एल ऐड करना है। अब अगर आप इसमें एच सी एल ऐड कर रहे हैं तो आप क्या देख पा रहे हैं यहाँ पे, यू कैन सी दैट कि ये एक एसिड है और ये एक अल्कोहल है। तो एसिड प्लस अल्कोहल गिव्स वॉट, एसिड प्लस अल्कोहल गिव्स एस्टर, राइट। सो हियर द एस्टरीफिकेशन इज टेकिंग प्लेस। अगर एस्टरीफिकेशन होता है तो उसमें जो एडवांटेज होता है, द फर्स्ट थिंग इज कि आपको अगर एक्वस एच सी एल यूज़ कर रहे हो, एच सी एल यूज़ करते हो, तो इन दैट केस द रिएक्शन इज प्रोसीड इन द राइट हैंड साइड। मीन्स द थिंग इज हियर इफ आई यूज द एच प्लस, इन दैट केस दिस प्रोडक्ट इज गोइंग टू फॉर्म। हाउएवर वॉट हैपन्स इफ यू हैव एस्टर एंड वी वॉन्ट टू कन्वर्ट दैट एस्टर इन टू अल्कोहल और एसिड। सो इन दैट केस द एसिड एंड बेस बोथ कैन बी यूज, बट वेन यू आर गोइंग टू मेक द एस्टर यूजिंग द एसिड एंड अल्कोहल, सो यू नीड टू चूज ऑनली एसिड। सो हियर इन दिस केस this will shift will in right direction, right? So A will shift in right. So from the option you can see that either this third one or either this third one or the first one will be correct. Now if I talk about this one, so what is happening here, if I am adding the H plus, so this H plus will coordinate with this O minus and cyanohydrin formation is taking place. So in that case also the equilibrium will shift to the right hand side only, right? So in both the cases actually the equilibrium will shift to right hand side, so that's why the first would be the correct option, right? Now let's talk about the next one. The next question is the compound that exhibits sharp band at 3300 and 2150 centimeter inverse in the IR spectrum. Now if I try to draw the structure for this one butane, so from here what we will have, C triple bond C and 1 2 3 CH2 and this CH3, right? So from this itself it will be confirmed to you that, so this C and this CH2 bond, this triple bond and this CH2 bond which we have over here is actually that gives in the range of around 2150, and this terminal alkyne which we have over here is actually this gives IR in range of 3300. So first will be the correct option. We don't need to go for the second, third and the fourth one. If you can try out the IR data, you can relate with the second B, C and the D option. Now let's talk about this third one. In the 1H NMR proton spectrum of dilute solution of a mixture of acetone and dichloromethane in CDCl3. Here what we have, dichloromethane in CDCl3 exhibit two singlet of 1:1 intensity, molar ratio of acetone to dichloromethane in solution is. Now how you can solve this one? To solve this question, actually you need to first find out the signals for the acetone. If I talk about the acetone, so what happens, C double bond O CH3, so here total we have the 6 hydrogen, right? So 6 hydrogen we have in this case. Now if I talk about the dichloromethane, so in that case what we have, here Cl, Cl and this H and this H, only 2 hydrogens are there, fine. So you can see that here the number of hydrogens are actually the 3 times higher than this one, right. So if you have 1:1 intensity for both of these, to maintain this 1:1 intensity actually I need to multiply with this 3, right. So if I will multiply this with 3, so 3 more means 4 more hydrogens will be needed, so it will become 6 hydrogens, so that will actually maintain the intensity. So in that case only I will get the 1:1 intensity. So here the correct option will be actually for the acetone that will be 1 and for the dichloromethane that should be 3. So B will be the correct option over here, right. Now let's talk about the next one. Intense band generally observed for a carbonyl group in the IR spectrum is due to, why we get intense band for the carbonyl group. So the first, if I talk about the IR, so in case of IR we get the spectrum just because of the dipole moment, right. So this is not the correct answer, this is not the correct answer, this is not the correct answer, but here the correct answer will be this D option, the dipole moment change in due to CO bond stretching is large, right? So this will be the correct option. So D is the correct option because of the dipole moment. Actually, this is change in dipole moment because of the CO bond stretching it last. So that's why we are going to get intense band in the carbonyl group. Fine. So now let's talk about the next one. The next one we have is the compound that gives precipitate on warming with aqueous AgNO3. So now how you can solve this one? So if I go for this one, so in this case actually I will get something like this. Here the double bond and positive charge will come over here, and if I go for this one, so double bond and positive charge will come over here because Br will be removed, right? But here if I go for this one, so in this case positive charge will come, and here if I go with this one, so positive charge again will come over here. So these all three, actually you can see that these all are not aromatic, but instead this one is aromatic in nature, right? In aromaticity we have discussed about it. If this is aromatic in nature, so 3 will be the correct option, right? So that is going to, the reaction will be favorable and this will take place. Now let's talk about this one. So here we are treating with the Br2, so C double bond OAG. So C double bond CO2 is getting removed over here, so CO2 will be released, right? And here the carbene won't be formed over here, right? But instead of carbene, what we will have is free radical intermediate will be formed, because at the bridge side position we cannot have carbon ion and the carbocation. So here the free radical will be at this position and the reaction will proceed by the radical mechanism, right? And once this will proceed by the mechanism so this is also, this reaction is also called as Hans-Dicker reaction, right? You can find this kind of example in the reactive intermediate series. So if you have watched that, so definitely you can solve such kind of question related to the carbene and all, right? So now let's talk about the next question, which is the most stable carbocation for the conformation of the following compound is. If I talk about the most stable conformation about this one, so in this case just look at these all. So these two cannot be the option because these are the less stable as compared to these all, right? So in this case, if I talk this methyl is like this, if the methyl is like this, so in this case actually what is happening, because we have double bond, so here the repulsion will be over here, right? So once the repulsion will be over here, so that is making it unstable because of the steric hindrance. This is making it unstable, and this is also known as 1,3 allylic strain. 1,3 allylic strain is also occurring in this one, but here the methyl is at the axial position and this is at the equatorial, you can say, right? Just like the equatorial, not at the equatorial, but just like the equatorial. So in this case there is no allylic strain, so A will be the correct option. In the stereochemistry video you can understand this, right? Now let's talk about the next one, which is the major product formed in the following reaction is. And now how you can solve this one? To solve this one, if we are using this NaBH4 and this CCl3, so see this CCl3 will coordinate with this oxygen, right? This oxygen CHO which we have over here, right? So once this will coordinate with the oxygen which we have over there, so what is going to happen? So how the reaction will proceed in this case? Let's see. If you have, in this case, if you have this CHO and you have been given also this ketone, right? Aldehyde and ketone both are present in this case. So means that if you have aldehyde and ketone both are present in this case, so if you are using this CCl3, if you are using this CCl3, so that will selectively reduce this ketone, right? So once the ketone will be reduced, so in this case how the reaction will proceed? So this CCl3 which we have, that will coordinate with this oxygen. And once this will coordinate with this oxygen, so that is going to form like O plus CCl3 we will have over here, right? And this NaBH4, it get converted into what? Na plus plus BH4 minus, right? So this one hydrogen will be delivered at this position. So this carbonyl center, and after delivering at this position, what will happen? This will become, this bond will shift and that will become OCCl3, and here one hydrogen will be added at this position, right? And after that, if we are using this MeOH and H2O and this CCl3 which you can see over here, actually that will be reduced, and here the OH, it will get converted into the OH only, and CCl3 will be removed. So selectively this will be reduced. So in this case the correct option will be this. Actually, this would be the correct option. So for this, this is the correct option, right? Now if I go for this one, the correct relation between the following compound is, and here what you can do actually, this is above the plane and this is here also above the plane, and here this Cl is below the plane and here this is above the plane. Just you can see that actually what I do, if I rotate this molecule, try to understand, if I rotate this molecule, so this OH which is above the plane that will go below the plane, and the hydrogen which is below the plane that will come above the plane, and the Cl which is above the plane at this side that will come this side, right? If I try to rotate this molecule by 180 degree through this angle, so in this case what is going to happen, actually I'm going to get the same molecule. So that is the reason why they both will be actually homomer, right? They both will be the homomer in this case. I hope you are getting. And also what you can do actually, but if you are not confirmed, if you are not confirmed up to this much, so you can go to find out the RS configuration for this chiral center, and here hydrogen is below the plane and here hydrogen is above the plane, right? At this point I am talking. So here if we have the hydrogen is above the plane, so here you can assign the RS configuration and you can find out. Just pause the video and try to find out, and then you will get to know that you are going to get the homomer only, right? And here how 1, 2 and this is 3, so 1, 2, 3, like R will be at this position, and here if I go with this one, so 1, 2 and 3, hydrogen is above the plane, so here I am getting S, so instead of S it will become R, so they both are actually R, right? So that is the reason why we are saying, why I am saying that this is the homomer, right? I hope it's clear up to this much. Now let's talk about the next question, which is the correct order of heat of hydrogenation for the following compound is. If I talk about the stability, so more the stability you will have, and lesser will be the heat of hydrogen, right? So what happens actually, the trans alkenes are usually the more stable, right? And more the number of alpha hydrogen. So here if I talk about this one, so 3, 3, 3, total 9 alpha hydrogen. And here if I talk about this one, so this is cis, but 3 and 2, 3 to 5 alpha hydrogen, and here also 3 to 5 alpha hydrogen, and here if I talk about this one, only 2 alpha hydrogen, right? So here this is trans and this is trans, so first of all this 4 will come, 4, and after that this 2 will come, this 2, right? And after that what will happen, this first will come first, and then this third one, because this is the cis one, right? So because this is the cis one, so that will have the more heat of hydrogenation, right? Now let's talk about the next, which is among the following the correct statement about the ribose are. So what happens in case of ribose, so you need to understand this example really well, then we can proceed with the next one. For example, on the reduction with NaBH4, it gives optically inactive compound. So for the structure of ribose, if I talk, so structure of ribose is something like this. So here we have 3 OH, 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 and this OH, H, H, and H, and here what we have, CH2OH, and here what we have is CHO, right? If I treat it with NaBH4, what will happen? This aldehyde, which you can see over here, actually that will get converted into the CH2O, OH. So now it will become OH, OH, and OH, 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 and this OH. Because of plane of symmetry, actually this will be optically inactive. If this is optically inactive, so this will be the correct option. So A is the correct option. So you can say that either A will be correct or B will be correct. Now on reduction with menthoic HCl, it gives furanoside, right? So you don't need to go for this option because B is already mentioned in both the cases, right? So you don't need to go for this one. But if you want to solve, so instead of saying going with this one, once we will discuss about our carbohydrate, so in that case we are going to discuss actually how the reaction will proceed. Now if I go for this C option, so on reduction with Br2CaCO3 water, it gives optically inactive compound. And the next one we have, the it gives tolerance test, right? So with this option, D is correct because ribose gives the tolerance test. So with this option, we can say that A, B and this D, A will be the correct option. But even you try for this one, B and this C, right? Once we will discuss about our carbohydrates, so in that case we are going to discuss, because if I will try to solve these both, so in that case video will become very longer and it won't come in one video. The video will become very much longer, right? So now the next question is, if I talk about the next question, so it is based on the natural product, biogenetic precursors for the natural products and belliferon among the following is. So for this, actually cinnamic acid will be the correct option, right? And how the cinnamic acid, you must have studied in your MSc, and in that case you will see that this proceeds via the cinnamic acid, right? So if this proceeds via the cinnamic acid pathway, so in that case the cinnamate is formed, and that is the reason why we are having the cinnamic acid is used over there. So in that case, actually this is the reason why we get, right? That is little complicated one, because the natural products nobody remembers at all. So this will be the correct option. You can find this problem in your MSc notes. If you have your MSc notes, so you can go and check, right? So you can find about these all. So now the next question, the number of signals in the C13 1H NMR spectrum, here proton spectrum of R4-methyl pentane 2-all-R. So pentane 2 all is there, right? And at fourth position we have methyl. So 1, 2, 3, 4 and this 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Pentane, at 4 position we have methyl CH3, at 2 position we have R configuration, right? So I can assign R at hydrogen at below the plane, so that will make it easy. So this is what R, right? So here OH will be above the plane. So once OH will be above the plane, 1 and this is 2 and this is 3. So like this R configuration we have, right? Rotation clockwise. So this is the way. So number of signals, how many signals we will have? 1 hydrogen for this one, second hydrogen for this one, 3, 4, 5. Right? So five kind of hydrogens we are getting over here. But actually we need to find out the C13 signal, right? So C13 number of carbons, so different carbons 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and this is the sixth one. So total signal will be 6, right? So 6 is the correct answer. I hope you are getting, because those 6 different types of carbons are present, so that is the reason why we are getting the option as 6. Now let's talk about the next one. So here the next one we have is this one. So this problem, such kind of problem we have already discussed in the reduction reaction. If you haven't watched those videos, go and watch in the reagents chapter, right? So all kind of reagents which are possible for the reduction reaction, everything, selectivity and all, that has been discussed over there. So you can go and watch that. NaBH4, so in that video I had discussed that here, because of this methyl group which is present over here, so this H minus won't attack from this side. So H minus will attack from this side. So once this will attack from this side, so O will come this side. So here in the option, either this O which you can see over here, so that O will come this side, right? But here apart from this, we have this ester group. So ester won't be reduced at all, right? NaBH4 won't reduce the ester at all. This selectively reduces aldehyde and ketone, right? So NaBH4, that will reduce this ketone which is present over here. So here this OH will come this side and rest will be just like whatever we have. So here fourth will be the correct option, right? So this is the correct option. Now let's talk about the next problem, which is example of pericyclic reaction. So here, because you can see that cyclization has taken place, so let's see how we can proceed. So if I talk about this one, so this has total number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and total 9 carbon. So how I can write it? I can also write it like this. Here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and this is 6th, 7, right? I can write it like 7, double bond, 7 double bond and 8, and this CH2 and this one more H, like this. So what will happen if this proceeds via in reaction, right? So this will proceed via in reaction. So what will happen, this H which you can see over here, that will come this side, and this will come this side, and that is, that will come this side, right? So what will happen, this will abstract this proton, and this will go over there, and this hydrogen bond will shift over there. So in this case what we are going to get is something like this. Here this will, at two position we will have methyl group, right? We will have methyl group, and here at this position we will have this, something like this. So can we see any option like this? Yeah, we have A is the option, right? So A will be the correct answer over here. So A is the correct answer. Now let's talk about the next one. So the next problem is, the major product formed in the following reaction is. Now let's see how you can solve this one. Now to solve this one, actually you need to proceed via the reaction mechanism. Let's see how we can do this. So here we have this electrophilic carbon center, right? So this will attack at this position. So once it will attack at this position, so what is going to happen, this will become O minus, right? Like this, this will become O minus, and here what we will have, N H N, here what we will have NH2, positive charge it will have, and here we will have NH2, like this, and here O, like this, it will remain as it is, and rest thing won't be affected at all, because you can see, yeah, here it is affected. Yeah, so we need to write this one as well. Now let's see how we can go for the next. And in the next part, what will happen, actually this O minus which we have over here, this will get proton from this HCl, you can say. So it will become OH, right? So once it will become OH, so one hydrogen can also come go from here, NH2, from this NH2 one hydrogen can go, and this will become OH, and because we have acid over here, so that will become OH2 plus. So once that will become OH2 plus, I am writing directly, so it can get easily removed. So this will become NH, right? So this will become what? This will become NH, and this, by transfer of this lone pair, actually that can be removed. So here minus H2O will be removed from here, and here what we will have is like this. Here we will have methyl, and here this double bond, like this, and here what we have is double bond and positive charge, single bond NH2. Now in the next step we have used this base, right? Once you have this base, so this is going to abstract the proton from here, so that will become NH minus. So how the reaction will proceed, let's see. Double bond and positive, single bond NH minus, like this, right? So once this will become minus, so in this case what will happen, so once you have this, something like this, so this bond will shift over there, and this bond will shift over there, and this will break. So once this cyclize, once this epoxide which we had over here, actually once that will break, so NET3 which we had over here, that will become NHET3, positive charge it will have, right? So iske upar jo positive charge hai, what will happen, it can easily actually abstract the proton, and this will become OH. So it will become OH, like this. So here what I am going to get is OH. So this OH is actually below the plane, right? And here we have this methyl, and here what is going to happen, double bond is present over here, and double bond NH, like this, something like this we have. Again NET3 jo hai, actually ye fir se is proton ko abstract karega. And again agar isko abstract karta hai, so in that case what we are going to get is, what we are going to get is actually N double bond N, like this, and this will become negative, like this, right? So agar ye negative banega fir se, so in that case what is going to happen, सो अगर ये फिर से नेगेटिव बनता है, तो अगेन ये यहाँ पे शिफ्ट होगा, एंड दिस बॉन्ड विल ब्रेक, राइट? एंड हियर एवरीथिंग इज सेम लाइक व्हाटएवर वी हैड, एंड हियर व्हाट वी आर गोइंग टू गेट इज actually here negative charge will come at this position and OH is below the plane, and this negative charge which we have over here is actually that will abstract the proton from jahan se ye NH3 positive, yahan se ye fir se proton le lega. And in this case the product what we will have is double bond like this, and OH will be below the plane like this. So this will be the product. In this case you can see that OH is above the plane, so this won't be the correct option, but C will be the correct option, right? Now let's see the next question, which is anti-tuberculosis drug among the following. So in this case here what happened, ethambutol which we have is actually anti-tuberculosis, and isoniazid, so that is also anti, right, anti-tuberculosis. So ye dono jo actually drugs hain, ye dono anti-tuberculosis hain. Yeah, so that's all for this video, and this was the last question actually which was asked in CSIR June 2015. So jitne bhi 2 marker question the organic se, sare ke sare 2 marker question humne solve kiye, and we saw that actually nothing was much difficult over that if I accept the natural product part or ye drug wagera part wale part, because in this case actually you need to remember these all things. If you are currently in MSc, तो आपको ये सब सारी चीज़ें पता होंगे. अगर आप नहीं हैं तो यू कैन मेक ए लिस्ट ऑफ दिस और फिर आप देख सकते हो. इवन अगर नहीं भी किया तो भी कोई बात नहीं, बिकॉज इन द एग्ज़ाम यू हैव लॉट ऑफ ऑप्शन, राइट? सो आप ऑप्शंस भी देख सकते हो. ये एक दो क्वेश्चन आपको ऐसे मिलेंगे जहाँ पे नेचुरल प्रोडक्ट और कुछ ऐसे रिएजेंट भी होंगे जो शायद आपको पता नहीं हो, या फिर कुछ ऐसे थियोरेटिकल क्वेश्चन जो आपको पता नहीं हो, बट इन CSIR नेट एग्ज़ाम सो यू हैव सो मेनी चॉइसेस फॉर दैट, सो यू कैन सेलेक्ट दैट. So that's all for this video, and ये question, yeah, anti tubercular drug, fine. So that's all for this video, and thank you so much for watching this video. और जैसा भी आपको ये video लगा आप बताइए please कैसा है, तो हम उसके according फिर से नए videos बनाएंगे. और अगर कोई और method try करना रहेगा तो we will try that to solve previous question, right? So that's all for this video. Yeah, thank you so much and bye, take care.